recognition and dance
this
gesture recognition. I heartily welcome you to this workshop, and I thank you again to give your consent to be one of the expert speaker. Ma'am, with this, I request you to take the session. With this, I
thank you so much for inviting me for such a nice workshop. I will surely present. Just give me 1 minute. Okay. Are you audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay. Hello. Hello.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Is it visible, the presentation?
Presentation is not visible. You are audible.
No, no. No.
Now?
No, no, it is not visible.
Now?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, it's coming. Yeah,
yeah, now it is coming.
Okay. Should I start?
Yes, yes, please.
So a very good afternoon to all the participants. Now I'm going to start my presentation. Sorry for the interruption. In this class, I will discuss about the overview of overleap. After telling the overview of overleap, then I will practically demonstrate how it created. For example, to create conference and journal thesis and resume. And there are basic code such as how to create table figure and how to create the bibliography. I think you yesterday you did class of Paramartha sir, no? So you have you have knowledge about the basic code. I will not repeat that things, but I will give some of the example, and I will tell you about the comparison of overleap with shared latex. Okay. Now I want to discuss about the overleap. What is overleap? It is a collaborative cloud-based latex used for documenting, such as writing, editing, publishing scientific document. I think that all of the students are from computer science background. If you are not, then you have knowledge about the Windows PowerPoint presentation and basic of the Windows documenting. So how we create it and the documenting things in very nice way and without going to formatting or everything, that I will discuss. In overleap, it is possible. The overleap is mainly used for communicating and sharing your work effectively with colleague or supervisor and the general public often requires the preparation of suitable presentation. The template of Oberlip make it easy to create such a presentation, and the resulting set of slide is available for distribution in PDF format. So if you are not understand from the slide, then you don't worry, I will go for the practical demonstration. Now I want to discuss some of the line for about the history of Oberlip. The first shared latex in 2011 was known as Write Latex. That time there was not so much facility in the Write Latex. Then after that, with collaborating scientific writing, they launched beta version of Oberlip on 16th January 2014. And in 2007, after merging the shared latex in released Oberlip by combining feature from both into the single cloud-based platform hosted at oberlip.com. So you can do the Oberlip, the whole Oberlip in the website oberlip.com. This is the main front page of this is the front page of LaTeX, Oberlip. When you go through the URL, that is type www.oberlip.com, then this page will be shown. And in that page, you can register in your name. If you want to take care of your project or everything sharing with your guides or any other colleagues, then Oberlip is very perfect for that. You can register your email ID with password, then after login page, then you will get this page. And in this page, you can create your new project. The new project is option. There may be blank project, or you can upload the existing project or academic journal, book, book letter. Every format are already available. You don't go for that you have to format this. You can make your resume, CV, presentation, thesis, and everything. And for example, now I want to show that if you want to create one journal, then this portion, this page will appear. And in this page, you can see that if your journal is in IEEE format, then this is the IEEE format, and another format is also available, that is LNCS, the lecture noted computer science, and the optical society. This for every journal there are templates are available, and you can choose in your journal where you want to publish. You can select from that. After this is the example of the main page, and in the main page, the .txt file, you can write your own code, and then you can compile here. And this is the example of showing the how to write the abstract and introduction. There are so many sections are there. If you are not understand, then don't worry. I will go for the practical demonstration, then you can understand. And you can upload your images or files or image that available that is need for your project. In this way, you can upload. And from this also, you can download your source code. Also, you can download your PDF versions. And another most important things of Oberlip or any documenting, any LaTeX document, one important things is the bibliography. So in what happened, in case of you writing journal or thesis or conference, you can write in it in manually, the reference. But after certain times, if you're doing PhD or if you are doing long time research, after certain time, you will forget that what are the paper you read. Then what happened in Oberlip or in LaTeX, it is very good things that you can build one repository that what paper you learn. You can build one repository from 1 to 10. Hello,
madam. Just one interruption. Can you please make the full screen mode?
Yeah, it is in full screen mode. You are not visible. Eh?
No, actually, you have shared the other one, the full screen one, you have not shared.
Okay.
Yeah, you please share your entire screen, then make it the slideshow.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, the full screen is visible. You can now, start the slideshow.
Okay. Now yeah. Is it okay now?
Yes, yes, now it's okay.
What I tell you that how you can build a repository for your research, what paper you have learned, that this is the very, very important things of any researcher, that you keep track of that what paper you have learned. So you can build your repository whenever you write, and you can refer particular paper, you can refer from the repository. No need to go for all the paper. Whatever portion you have write, you just call the reference ID. And in this way, you can refer your paper. And this is called the bibliography repository. And this file will be written in the biblio.bib extension. Now, one example is thesis. How to write thesis? That inside of the new project, you go for the thesis, and then you can show these pages available. I will show you later. Then this page is available, and whatever template you are matching and you like, whatever template, you can do your thesis very easily. And this is the text text portion, and here you can see that this is the file of thesis.txt. .txt extension, you can write your own thesis, and also you can build up your chapter wise, and so you can call the thesis in this way. By input and input acknowledgement in this way. All the pages you can refer. And the, like this here, you can see that is input. In this page, the first, in this page, in this is referred the input abstract page, that is acknowledgement page input, by calling the another pages. And here the one page is that for introduction, you can call. And this is the example of presentation, how you create presentation. All the template are there. Whatever you choose, you can choose, and you can prepare your presentation. And now I want to demonstrate that how this is work. If you are not understand about my lectures or from the slide, then now you can understand. You can type overleaf. Is it visible now? Hello.
Yes.
Hello. Overleaf.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is coming.
You can type overleaf.com, then the page is come. Is it same as I demonstrate? This page is come. And I already registered, so I log in with my email ID. Like my email ID is Dr. Hansi Devi at the rate email.com. And you create your own password to register. So there are so many projects are there, but you want to create your own new project, or you can upload your existing project. First, you can see here. To log out and log in. So this is one menu. You can upload your own project, existence project, or you can create your new. New project. So from here you can see that you can create your own project or upload existing project, and you can prepare your CV or presentation and formal work and academical journal. So now I giving one example of that upload project, that how can you upload. Already this project is with me, so I can show you that how you can format. You can create by your own. This is the project. Here you can see that here one text file is there. This you can see the from rename, you can see that dot text is available. So where the dot text is available, you can write your own way. So this is the already template, this is the already code are available. If you don't know about anything about these things, you can just simply change your name. Whatever you want, you can just simply you can change. For example, you want to know that your title of the paper. I am here just writing the title of the, that is investigation of cyber security. if you compile here. This is change. So you can change your title, whatever you know. You don't know about this code, but you want to change this from the PDF file. You can see, and you can directly see the code from the PDF file. Go to the PDF location in code. Suppose a student name you want to change, then you just click here and you go to the source page. So this is the student name. If you want to change, suppose like Priya. Priya Roy and supervisor name, suppose she is under me, and if you want to and now, if you recompile, you just see that the student name and the supervisor name will change under the guidance of that. So whatever the institute, here already Department of Computer Science and Engineering. Suppose you want to change it to Tripura University, Department of IT, then you can change here, Department of IT. Compile IT, that is information technology. So here you can see that the department name is changed. And here already the section and subsections are there. If you want to write the abstract, already the abstract portion is there. Here you can change the abstract. Here you can change, suppose, private security. You written like that. If you recompile, then according to you, your abstract is there. And you can change your keyword, head section introduction. You can create your own section or you can create your subsection, whatever you need. Suppose you don't need the literature survey part, although it is very necessary. Suppose you don't need this section, network security section. If you see that in here, the network security is there in section 3, but you don't need. Then you can remove it. You recompile, then your section will, this section will change. So you can change it your own way. Like under section, you can create your subsection, you can create your sub-subsections. And now I want to discuss how to create the table. These are the format of the table. You can change your own way. This is the format of shown figure, include graphic. So you can change your graphic pictures. Here, the in example, the graphic is like that, but you want to bigger the size you want to do, then you can bigger here. The size of the image is bigger. So you can change your size of the image, and you can change whatever figure you want then in this template. So from this, you can see that you don't, you have, if you have no knowledge about the any coding, then you can copy it and you can change it. And in this way, you can create your own journal or anything. Now I want to discuss the most important things of that, that is how to create the bibliography. Here one file is there, that is .bib. So whatever if you want to if you write here in the text file in the last portion here you can also use your manually bibliography, but if you want to create your own repository for the bibliography, that whatever paper you have read, then in .bib file you can create your own repository. Now what are the format in this format, where in this format is available? If you want to know, suppose for example one paper is like the Tikar's Guide to the Galaxy, then in Google, and it is better to find out the paper from the scholars Googles than the Googles, because in Googles there are so many papers that are not so much authenticated. So in scholars Google, to type your scholars Google, it is better if you want to do good research than to find paper from the scholars Google. So in scholars Google, if you write is the paper name, this is the citation portion, and from this you can copy this BibTeX file. You can see that this format is already available, then you can copy Ctrl C, and then in this .bib file you can just paste it. And whatever file you want to refer in case of reference, for example, I want to refer the paper, this one, Eroid 2019. There is one title, you can change your own way. A survey, if the title is not common, you have one pattern to for this, then you can change your own title. Book, a survey. That in text file, now you want to cite here a survey. So how you write? Cite inside of curly bracket, you write a survey. Better you copy it because it is very case sensitive. A survey, and copy. A survey, I think it is okay. Then our proposed system, now you want to see where the refer, this is one. You can see, you can, for this button you can go to the location page, that is source file, and as well as you can go to the your PDF format, but it is not available in the share latex. It is mainly basically available in that is manual latex. It is available in the overlay, that you want to go to the source page immediately, you can see. Now this is the citation one, whatever written in the citation one, this paper is citation one. So in this way you can keep track your bibliography, and you can build one repository for bibliography. And this is the, and these are the some, how can you upload images? You can upload from here, you can drag and drop. And this how you refer the images, I want to show this thing. Image file, how can you, first you have to upload there, then you can refer. Begin figure, this name and this name will be the same. That is, if it is .png extension, that is block diagram system.png. Here the block diagram system.png. These are so case sensitive, so you have to remember that the name will be the same. So in this way you can upload your figure, And also you can create your table like that. One table in this format you can, I have created one table for communications, that is COM1 and COM2. Long range of cyber security table. That is long range of cyber security caption. This table is format is that. If you want to change, that is you want to change the communication is like information. This column, if you want to change, then you can change here like this information. You compile. Here you can see that this communication is replaceable with the information. So in this way you can create your own table, you can size, you can, this is automatic. If you want to put your column size, then you can put here the size of the column, that is 2.5 or 3.5 in this way. If you want to see the only PDF file, then from here you can see the full screen of the PDF file. If you want to download, you can download the PDF file. If you want to download the source file, then you can download the source file from here. In this way, you can download. I think you are clear about, you can create your own. Should I give more example? Or you know? Hello? Hello?
You can contact.
Hello? Hello, participant? Do you have any question regarding this? Participant, I want to ask you, do you have any question regarding this? No question. Now I want to continue my slide. These are the demonstration. If you have find any problem, then you can mail me. Or from Google, you can find what are the problem. If you want to learn some code, then in Google already in they are and these are available. You can find. Now I want to discuss about the comparisons of Overleaf with traditional LaTeX. So I think you are clear about the code because already sir has taken a class yesterday. So you have clear idea about that. Now, what are the benefits and what are the demerits of this Overleaf over LaTeX? Or first, I want to say that LaTeX is installing and running LaTeX on your local machine. You have to, for LaTeX, you have to download the LaTeX file and you have to install it in the in your local machines. Then what is the advantage of the LaTeX? Advantage of the LaTeX is that if you are offline, then you can compile your document and you can create your own document in the offline. This is the example and this is the benefit of the LaTeX. And downside, that is the limitations of the LaTeX is that if you refer to other files in your body, you need to keep track of the folder structure. In case of Overleaf, what happened? If you want to upload some folder substructures that you no need to keep the track. You just can upload, and from drag and drop you can refer the file. This is the benefits of overlay. But in case of LaTeX, if you refer any files in another folder, then you have to keep this track and you have to upload this path. Additionally, you may be required to download and install packages manually. You know it before overlay. I think you have used the LaTeX and on your machines. And also one thing, in case of LaTeX, offline LaTeX, what happened? If you run some file, then you want you have to upload from the Google or anything. If you refer something, then in your machines, then. Then download the download the dependency file every time in LaTeX. So though the student who are very old, at least 5 or 6 years back, they did research, they knew about the LaTeX, because that time the overlay is not so much popular. That time we did our LaTeX, our every document in LaTeX. So we are very much tricky and very much frustrated for this dependency file. We have to upload for everything. You have to upload this dependency file and you have to install that. These are the disadvantages. So now in this presentation, I am basically focused on this popular based, that is closed web-based LaTeX editor, that is Overleaf. The upside of this online editor is that is the advantage of this, that all necessary files in the cloud, all necessary files are stored in the cloud, and that you can access your file from every machine wherever you are, just in the split of LaTeX. This means that it also ensures that you have all files nicely stored in the necessary working directory. Moreover, Overleaf allow a real-time collaboration with other users, has a smooth integration with popular citation system, and offer a wide range of templates. The basic version of Overleaf is free, but if you want to update, then there is some subscription plan to collaborate with more colleagues or to add additional features. But everything has advantage, then there must be disadvantage. Disadvantage of that is that the downside is that in order to compile your document via Overleaf, an internet connection is always required. And one thing you can do, you can download the source code, and you can local LaTeX compiler on your machine is still possible. So it is not a so much limitation. There is so much limitation. You can also use it in offline, but it is better to use in online. Another thing, if you want to share the document, then it is better to use it in online. It is important to note that it is possible to reproduce all steps using local LaTeX editor on your computer, and can also download the .zip file, the template. Thank you. If you have any question or any doubt during the practical session, you can discuss. I'm giving you the time.
Thank you, madam. Thank you very much for your valuable presentation. I think our participants will get benefit from this. So for the next session, we'll start soon. It's a 5-minute break. So next session will be taken care of by Dr. Dipankar Deb, MMD College, Govdop Tripura. He will be covering IBM Quantum Experience. That is a quantum computing simulator. Please come back within 5 minutes.
Okay, thank you.